Aloha Star Wars fans, Fly Guy from FlyGuy.net here with another widescreen review. Hopefully you're enjoying these on another Lego set. This time set 9491. Let me zoom in and I'll give you the usual high def close up. And again, if you've never seen a channel, they're all in high def and widescreen now. Blah de blah de blah. But you'll see some controls on YouTube if you want to whack that up to see it. And there's the box right up close, 9491 Geonosian Cannon. Had this ages ago, but just never get a chance to build it and review it, but here we go. Couple of Geonosians, we get Barriss Offee and a cool as Commander Gree in the pack. So it's a couple of new, brand new minifigures there. In fact, well, the Geonosian is one, but it's just different paint. On the back of that, you'll see some of the play features the cannon has. A little bit of a story around it, but it's basically got some flip missiles. And that's about it, really. It moves up and down. So, on with the other bits and pieces in the pack, just to give you, obviously, that is the standard instruction booklet. Just one of the small features that seem to be added this year. There's a bit of a mini cartoon comic in the back of the instruction manual, but otherwise, same old LEGO instructions if you've seen them before. Minifigure-wise, let's start off with Barriss Offee. Now, she has been in another set before. I think she had a black hood the last time, so let me zoom that right up close for you so you can get to see that right in your face. There we go. So, again, I believe the figure was out before. Very cool, beautifully done on the face with the makeup that she has there. The eyes and the purple lips and the markings that that her clan or her tribe or whatever she is has on her face. The tone of the flesh tone of the minifigure is exactly the same as basically she is within the movies and Clone Wars cartoon, etc. She's very, very different to the kind of flesh tone you'll see on the clones, so it matches the figure pretty exactly. Standard lightsaber, no difference, but nice little belt buckle there, the paintwork that's on it, that little love heart that's part of the symbol that she has. There is nothing printed on the back, just to show you, I'm not lying. It's pretty plain, and we get a basic blue cloak, and on top of that is the typical Jedi hood that you get. So that's Barriss Offee, the minifigure in the set. I'll show you Gree in a minute, who's my favourite. This one's very cool. This is the zombie Geonosian. Some really cool paintwork on the body. The rifle is one that's been seen in the LEGO mini series figures. Series 5, I think it was, with one of the space aliens or one of these figures anyway, the alien Conquest series of LEGO, but very cool. But the Geonosian's exceptionally smooth. Really nice gold paintwork on the torso and on the legs, and he's got a nice kind of half-shut eye face. Now the wings are a brand new piece, never seen before as far as I know in a LEGO set, and it's a plastic piece which you fold just like you normally would with kind of different pieces of capes and so forth, and I'll show you how they're kind of put together on the next minifigure. Same kind of a decor on the back, the kind of body armor the Geonosian has, and the gold around the belt. But check that little zombie face, fantastic. The only thing he doesn't come with is worms, and if you've seen the Geonosian episode where basically these guys turn into zombies, they have worms. Anyway, there's the other live Geonosian, and same kind of, and slightly different markings on the body, same blaster that we've seen in these series figures before, but it looks very much like the Geonosian kind of repulsor blaster they have. Slightly different wings, this guy's is not decayed and falling apart like the damage on this zombie one here. And there we go, but it's a plastic piece you fold over, and it's pretty tough. The only problem is trying to get it to, if you hold it down at the back, it looks a little bit more like the wings, but it normally sits up just a little high. So it maybe takes a piece of forcing down against a wedge or a piece of Lego to get the wings to look as they should. Just before I show you Gree, this is a quick look at the Geonosian cannon itself. It's really not that exciting, I have to say. Please let me know if you're excited with these kind of Geonosian things, because I'm really not. The Geonosian figures and the warriors, but this cannon, it's okay. I mean, it would have been nicer to get some kind of a more aggressive kind of vehicle than this. A couple of flick missiles at the bottom, you see them in luminous green. You push these elements back here, and out pop those two missiles there. It basically rotates and can move, tilt back and forth, and that's your lot. It's really not the most exciting thing whatsoever, and it really adds a lot of price to the pack when this could have been a very simple battle pack, but they've already got a couple of them out that were reviewed on the channel already. Whoops! So the final piece is Commander Gree. And there he is. Looking very like his Clone Wars version, and like the figure that they have in that line too. The belt that he has across there, green knees, green kind of standard clone helmet. Got a little bit on the back. And that's really it. What you've got underneath is a standard, sadly a standard clone head and clone face there. It would have been nice to get something that, even a piece of Lego that was would allow you to have a little Mohican, or double Mohican as he has in the show, but sadly nothing there. Got a standard Lego blaster, so nothing different whatsoever there. And that's pretty much it. Now I picked this set up at the very cool shopforme.com.au. Very, very cool bunch of guys. Thank you guys yet again for getting us this Lego. And there we go, lots of stuff. Give a shout to them. This is in Melbourne, Australia, but they also ship overseas. If you are overseas, make sure you check out chowrentoys.com, chowrentoys.com. They're also the second world's second largest Lego store in the world. They have a lot of Lego. Check them out, they're really worthwhile. Just before I go, the one thing I mentioned to you was the Geonosian wings, and this is what you get. It's basically a plastic sheet, and again, I've never seen this before in a Lego set, but the wings are made out of this soft plasticky material, and you just punch them out and attach them to the minifigures. So adds a bit of difference, and I guess it's makes a change from previous Geonosians, where basically they never supply any wings with them at all, as far as I know. So that is that set, 9491 Geonosian Cannon. It's out there in stores, and it's a little harder to find in some places than some of the other sets I've seen. So, but there you go. Let us know what you think, and hit the subscribe button up there, and you've got lots of cool videos straight into your inbox. And if you want to join the, I don't know, 1600, 1700 odd people that are on our Facebook page talking about Star Wars and all sorts of cool stuff, then head up facebook.com/flyguy.net, and we'll see you for another figure review soon. Cheers.